Over the past few months, governments, including the Canadian one, the United States, and UK, have all reported attempts by foreign agents to steal coronavirus vaccine research. China, Russia, and Iran have been implicated in the espionage efforts. Ben Buchanan is a Georgetown University professor and the author of The Hacker and the State, Cyber Attacks and the New Normal of Geopolitics. We've reached him in Washington. Professor Buchanan, thank you so much for making time for us.
Thank you for having me.
Professor Buchanan, I was reading through the report in the New York Times, and it's just fascinating. Now that we're dealing with this global pandemic, according to the reporting, every major nation state is now racing to get to this vaccine and spying to get to this vaccine. So why are these countries spying on each other rather than working together?
Well, that's a question that almost lends itself to a broader view of international relations. And I think the U.S. view is summed up by Chris Painter, who's a former head of cybersecurity for the State Department. And he said, in an optimal world, we would be cooperating, but we're not in that optimal world. And everyone's racing and everyone wants an advantage. And they're turning, as they often do, to their intelligence services and to their hackers to make that advantage possible.
And when we say spying, what are we talking about? What are some of the actions that these other agencies are taking?
One of the ones that definitely is in the repertoire is cyber espionage. So hacking into the computers of vaccine researchers and of laboratories and of pharmaceutical companies that are working on COVID research to try to figure out what it is they might know and how that might help the hacking nation get to a vaccine faster.
We understand that with China in particular, they've really focused in their, if you want to describe it, as spying technique into universities and various agencies that way. Why are they focused on universities?
Well, there's an old saying that bank robbers rob banks because that's where the money is, and hackers will go wherever the data is. And in many cases with COVID research, that research is being held or conducted at universities as well as pharmaceutical companies. And it makes sense that that's where the hackers would go to try to access that information before it's public to the rest of the world.
Now, Professor, is this a matter of good intentions for each individual state? They're trying to save lives. Certainly, we've seen the loss of life in countries like Russia, Iran, and China, very hard hit. Or is this about national prestige in the race to get the first vaccine? Or is this basically about money?
It's probably some combination of all of the above. My guess is money's not as much of a factor here as saving lives and prestige. Certainly, if you saw the Russian messaging around their, what they call a vaccine, I think it's remained to be clear if it is a vaccine, they're suggesting that it's a matter of prestige for Russia that they got to the vaccine first. Again, very speculative of whether or not that vaccine will work as intended. But I think if China or another nation were to achieve a vaccine first, and if hacking were to help, you could be sure they would make sure the world knew that.
Now, there is reporting that American intelligence officials are also engaged in spying on other countries. Now, is this for the same sort of reasons, or is this more of a defensive matter?
We don't have great insight into what American espionage is targeting. Certainly, a lot of the research is in the United States already, so they might not have as much incentive to spy for COVID purposes, but certainly they would spy to see how other nations are connecting their intelligence activities and to aid their defenses against those foreign hackers.
I want to talk to you about the World Health Organization and this implication by so many who are reporting on this issue that China has a particularly high amount of influence on the World Health Organization. Is that considered a form of spying? Is that considered, is there an concern there, because there are so many concerns that the World Health Organization didn't move as quickly as it could have on the issue of the virus, that they've not been as critical of the Chinese government in hiding information as they perhaps should have been. What concern is there? Because we know the U.S. has certainly pulled away from the WHO.
That's right. So there's a number of concerns here. I think the WHO concern precedes the espionage concern. That goes back to January or February, as you said, about the response in China and the criticism or lack thereof from the WHO. What the New York Times suggested this morning, however, is that China is using its position within the WHO to target its espionage. So it would get information, say, about which kind of vaccine research was most promising from the WHO, and the New York Times suggested it would then go and use that information to target its cyber espionage activities against those universities or those pharmaceutical researchers.
You know, for the average person, I can hear an individual saying, well, what do I care if all these big governments are spying on each other if it just gets us closer to finding that vaccine that would eventually be helpful to everybody? What is the inherent danger of the spying?
The United States officials said that part of their concern with the espionage was that hackers from other nations, either intentionally or unintentionally, would interfere with the research, potentially by altering some of the information or forcing researchers to go back and verify that nothing had been changed. And this has been a theme the United States government officials have mentioned for several months in saying that other nations should not be hacking into this kind of research.
Does it at all pose a risk to the research that the scientists are doing if they know that they're being spied on?
I don't know if there's a chilling effect here per se, but certainly it's the case, I think, that American government officials are right to worry that there's an accident risk of espionage and that could alter some of the information or some of the procedures or corrupt some of the data. And there's no doubt that espionage can get in the way, and that could be a concern.
So is there a solution to this? If you're a Canadian scientist, and I don't know to what degree Canadian scientists are being spied on, certainly our government has indicated that the hacking, the espionage is taking place. What can be done to protect our research? What can be done to make sure everything is above board?
Researchers can take the normal cybersecurity precautions, but I think some of the concern from the governments is that if they're spending their time worrying about cybersecurity, they're not spending their time doing COVID research, which of course slows things down. And I think the broader lesson here for those researchers, and indeed for Canadian and American citizens, is that this is a sign of where the world is right now, with facing a deadly pandemic, but still an enormous amount of mistrust. And in the face of that mistrust, governments turning to their hackers to gain advantage.
Wow, it's just a fascinating conversation. Professor Buchanan, thank you so much for your time and for your insights.